Welcome back, everyone. I am dropping some FedEx boxes in the recycle bin. Let's get into it. Hello. So one of my videos ideas that I wanted to do is explaining how pacemakers and defibrillators work to patients. I also use these terms and metaphors to describe pacemakers and my job to my friends and family members too. So I'm gonna take a seat and break it down for you. So pacemakers are for slow heart rates. Smaller than my palm, sits right under the clavicle. First thing I tell a patient, okay, pacemakers are for slow heart rates. This device is like a fancy clock. It's never gonna let your heart rate go lower than a set rate. Sometimes patients think it's gonna cure their AFib. That's not true. The pacemaker, if your heart decides to go fast, the pacemaker, all they can do is take a picture. Simple, right? Okay, defibrillators. A little bit bigger. They have a capacitor inside them. Same spot under the clavicle. Defibrillators are for life-saving therapy. So you can either have a defibrillator as primary prevention, so your heart is really sick, it's at risk for maybe going out of rhythm into a dangerous one, such as ventricular tachycardia or ventricular fibrillation. Instead of getting that external shock, we just know that they're at risk, so we'll implant a device. Other reason. So playing basketball, you know, all of a sudden feeling really tight, really short of breath, dizzy, pass out, require external shocking to reset their heart and get it back in regular rhythm. Because they have that event, they receive a device implant secondary to their unfortunate event. At the end of the day, defibrillators give life-saving therapy. It is so awesome when I see a patient that unfortunately got a shock, but it saved their life. That's the reason they're here with me, talking to me. So pacemakers for slow heart rates. If your heart goes fast, I can take a picture. Defibrillators are for life-saving therapy. They're a patient's insurance policy. I hope they never need to use it. That is my one wish. It feels like a donkey kicks you right in the chest, but it's there if they need it, which is important. And balancing medication as well as device programming will help ensure that that patient doesn't get inappropriately shocked. That would be bad. Okay, so we went over pacemakers for slow heart rates. We went over defibrillators for life-saving therapy. Now, trick question. My mom's a teacher, so. Which one of these devices is a pacemaker? You want to say just this one, right? What I called a pacemaker, but these are both pacemakers. All defibrillators are pacemakers. Not all pacemakers are defibrillators. So both of these are pacemakers. Only the one with the capacitor is a defibrillator. One more device. It is our Cadillac device because it costs a lot of money. So we always try to, you know, make the patient feel better that they're getting that Cadillac device. So it has three wires. The difference between these devices with two wires, we want to pace the heart 100% of the time to get a better squeeze on the muscle as a whole. The Cadillac device is not a guarantee that the patient's going to feel better and their heart failure is just going to go away. No. What we do want to say is that we hope that this patient is a super responder, okay? We have non-responders all the way up to super responders, right? Before they are taking the elevator to the fourth floor. Now, they can walk up the stairs no problem. They have energy, less shortness of breath, better quality of life. That's what we want to see. It doesn't happen all the time, but my main point, biventricular devices are for heart failure and they're meant to pace the heart 100% of the time to get a better squeeze on the muscle. These are the simplest ways to describe these complex devices, complex mini computers to patients and family friends. Maybe I'll dive in a little deeper of some indications and patient profiles that would get these devices, but I hope you learned something new. Just a recap. I'm trying to post a day in the life vlog once a week. And pacemakers are for slow heart rates. They'll never let a heart go lower than a set rate. Defibrillators have a capacitor. They're meant for life-saving therapy. We hope that you never need to use your device, but it is your insurance policy if you go into a dangerous arrhythmia. This will save you. Lastly, we have biventricular devices. They have three wires, two of which are around your ventricle, so it's giving a nice, even squeeze 100% of the time to give a better squeeze on the muscle, hopefully give you more energy, less shortness of breath, improving your heart failure class. So instead of taking the elevator, maybe you're making it up the stairs. Instead of feeling tired all day, you can chase around your grandkids. So thanks. I hope you guys learned something new. Just another day in biomedical engineer life. Okay, so just as a reminder, the purpose of this video was to demonstrate how, as a biomedical engineer, we are very technical, right? We have been taught how to talk in technical terms, write technical papers. But, you know, in the field, we're working with a lot of different people, patients, as well as customer support staff. So we need to learn how to break technical concepts down into layman terms that can be understood by everyone. Otherwise, you have your mom explaining to your friends and family that you're a doctor when that's by far not the truth. So that's how devices work in a nutshell. I hope you guys learned something new, and I hope to keep coming back for more content. Check out the weekly vlog. Let me know what you're enjoying, what else you want to see. I have a lot of different ideas, and I'm just going to keep creating those ideas until I'm done and see where this goes. So comment below what else you want to see more of, and I hope to deliver that to you. Thanks so much for tuning in. Bye, guys. Wait a second. Don't leave. If anyone had sharp ears and heard this buzzing in the background, I found out my neighbor was doing construction below me. This was my first reaction when I heard the noise. Usually it's very quiet. Numbers. It's a really weird sound from below me.